The Senate's probe into alleged extrajudicial killings is on hold because of the verbal tussle between Senators Richard Gordon and Leila de Lima. But for Senator Antonio Trillanes, the investigation must continue. Trillanes is also criticizing Gordon for already concluding that self-confessed hitman Edgar Matobato isn't credible. Trillanes adds Gordon shouldn't blame others if he missed what a witness said during a Senate hearing. Trillanes also questions why he and De Lima were not invited to Tuesday's Senate caucus.
He's determined apparently to shut this down, probably out of allegiance to President Duterte, but it's much of a cover-up. He was ready to believe the policemen, which we saw and I tested that they lied actually. So he showed his bias, and that's very unfortunate.
All right, we're going to talk now to Senator Richard Gordon, chairman of the Senate Justice Committee. Senator, good afternoon. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for taking our call.
Good afternoon.
Hi, this is Carmina Constantino, and you're live on ANC. We just played the soundbite of Senator Antonio Trillanes, basically saying that you've shown your biases and that you are sort of railroading this inquiry into extrajudicial killings or alleged extrajudicial killings. Your thoughts on that, Mr. Senator?
That's his opinion, and you know how Trillanes is. He goes off on the loose cannon. He just says anything that comes to his mind without thinking and reflecting. That shows severe immaturity, and that's why his record shows that. He conducts coups, then he surrenders, then he goes on and on. I don't want to go on a debate with Mr. Trillanes. He's not a serious person.
He also said in our interview with him this morning that he knew of the caucus, but that he wasn't invited. Therefore, his absence and Senator Leila de Lima's absence in the caucus yesterday. Your thoughts on that?
There was not a sit-down caucus. We all met together as agreed upon. He passed on. He was there. I told him that when he was passing by that you sent this fellow home, Matobato, without telling us, and he just went on a walk. We were already meeting. We're not even sitting down. We were just saying, tutuloy natin ang hearing. Mm. We're going to call, and we're going to do the extrajudicial hearing that has focus. Mm. No longer this Matobato, because Matobato has really shamed himself as well as his handlers. No? Mm. After all, he was brought in, even in the beginning, Senator De Lima and Senator Trillanes were not even admitting that they brought them in. In the end, they finally admitted that they were the ones who presented, they were the ones who protected him. So it's really, he says, she says, and we don't want to lose our focus on justice. This is the Committee on Justice. That's why Mrs. De Lima was taken out, because she lost her objectivity. And I didn't even want to. And by the way, if I was biased, why would I insist as a condition that Senator De Lima and Senator Cayetano be part of the committee? She was already practically booted out. And I said, no. I want Senator De Lima in. I want her to have a say. And if you count the number of times that we bent over backwards for Mrs. De Lima, and by the way, she said, you're in the first meeting, oh, he's very firm, he's very fair, you know, he's very committed, etc. And, you know, I thought it was okay. Mm. And if you look at the hearings, by the way, it was a 13-hour hearing.
Yep.
Carmina, when was the last time you heard the Senate committee going on 13 hours where the PNP Director General Bato was there, and all the other officers and all the other senators, and the policemen were waiting, and Matobato was waiting, until the time that we found out that there was evidence that was materially misheld, the information being that Matobato was pointing in the open hearing that he killed together with another policeman and six others, or four others, this guy, Macdum. Mm-hmm. In previous affidavits, he denied it. In previous affidavits, he said, I just saw it. In this third affidavit, he said he killed them. And there was a case in the NBI filed, and the policeman that the people that was charged there for Macdum was Matobato and four other people, or three other people. Mm-hmm. Not the ones he referred to in the committee on September 15, 2016.
Mm-hmm.
So it means that this witness is really just fooling around with us, and he is obviously coached and directed. So we have no more reason to call him, and we're not canceling the hearings. I've always been focused on what we're going to do about the extrajudicial killings, and we are going to continue with that. Let me assure the public against the headlines and against all the misinformation being scattered throughout the media that we're not going to continue with the hearings.
No, we asked Senator Trillanes about what exactly happened, what his version was prior to that walkout, what happened. Basically, he said this morning that, you know, egos were bruised and that you shouldn't blame others if you missed what a witness said during a Senate hearing. Basically saying that it was your fault, Mr. Senator Gordon, that you missed this particular detail. What do you say to that?
No, I did not miss it. I did not miss it. It was said in passing. The first one, I was not there, so I could not speak with authority. The second one, my focus was on the Turk who was proclaimed by this guy, Matobato, as a terrorist. But it cannot be denied. It cannot be denied because the papers are there also that Matobato referred to the policeman, the so-called Davao Death Squad. But the thing to say NBI, these were different names. And this time, in Matabatos, now he's saying that he was the one who killed them, along with the others. So how can you believe that? And in the meantime, if you will recall and take a look before the outburst and the walkout of Senator De Lima, I even told Senator Lacson, Lacson tayo partner, kasi niya, i-terminate na. Namumula na si Senator Lacson dahil niloloko nga kami. Sabi ko, no. It was just an oversight on the part of Senator De Lima. I said that several times, calmly, until I found out that Senator Trillanes sent the witness home at about 8:30 in the evening after probably he heard all the testimonies or the testimonies were beginning and in the middle of the testimonies that Matobato was already discredited completely. He was saying, the policeman was saying, how can I be part of that bombing when I was not even a policeman? This was a patrolman named Medina. Matobato said they were. Matobato is very free with his words. He said, President Duterte ordered. And of course, that's sensitive. So when we ask him, no, actually, it was this guy, Las Cañas, who said it. It was always hearsay. How can you rely on a witness that has killed, according to his own lips, 50 people and participated in about 1,000 of them, 1,000 killings?
Well, Senator,
obviously, this guy is a blowhard. And, you know, he runs around in Samal Island with an M14, with a 45. And, you know, The kidnapping for ransom involved a Kasidin law. And, you know, this guy obviously was in private business. It was a personal thing. That was not part of our investigation. The investigation was focused on extrajudicial killing.
All right, Senator, I asked Senator Trillanes about, you know, that moment when he allowed Edgar Matobato to go home.
Excuse me, Carmina, with all due respect.
Yeah.
Senator Trillanes was there. Was not there three-fourths of the time. Take a look. He was always out. He only came in when they were rushing in when the issue of concealment came out and that the issue that he sent the witness. Why don't you ask him? Why did he send him home?
I asked him that specifically.
Everybody waited for 13 hours.
Yeah,
13 hours.
I asked him that specifically, Senator Gordon, because I also, I was reading through what happened and I also found it questionable that he sent the witness home without even telling, not even Senator De Lima, not even the chairman of the Justice Committee. And his response was, as caretaker of Edgar Matobato, he had to assess the security situation and didn't want Edgar Matobato out in the streets late at night. But he sent him home at 8:30.
Then it is true that he is the handler. Why did they deny it? At the first hearing when I conducted, who brought this witness in? Both of them denied it. Senator De Lima even said, I had interviews with him. Senator Giuliani said he just brought him in, but he was just asked by Senator De Lima. So, in fact, they were the handlers. They were the coach, and I'm sorry I have to say this. And by the way, you will take the word of Senator Giuliani against all the members of the committee. It was Senator De Lima who walked out. Very petulant. We were very patient with him. I have been very patient with him because she's a lady. I respect her as a lady and as a confrere, as a colleague. But what did she do? She yelled, she walked out, and I don't know whether she wants to come back. There are questions on whether she wants to come back. That is unethical conduct. And if I'm contemplating ethical issues, I have to say that to the public because I have to, at the same time, school the public on orderly behavior. And who has been the paragon of this orderly behavior? Hasn't it been them? You can see Senator De Lima shouting and shouting all of the time. And you can see Senator Cayetano during the hearings of Senator De Lima, you know, turning off the microphone when he's not the chairman. He apologizes to Senator Cayetano. He should be apologizing to the whole Senate and to the country. You are elected to find the truth. You are elected to behave properly. That's why we have parliamentary rules. If they do not agree, then they raise a point of order. And I said, okay, go ahead, continue. But then said, no, I'm going to walk out. He cannot say, I will play with you so long as you play by my rules. No, the rules are there for everybody.